defiled and purged.
Anybody there? Did I hear something?
Find some bandages. Dusty roads call me again.
I can't remember the last time I saw a civilized land.
Thank you.
righteous death. Just looking for those. Doesn't hurt now. What do we have here? Spicy. Earth. ashes. They need it at some point, you never know. French. Ashes to ashes. Sleep now, forever! Into my gun already. Ooh, this one will hurt.
You have returned. I hope you managed to find what you were looking for. Would you kindly hear my request? I am simply asking you to listen to what I have to say. I am certain that my friend vanished in these mountains. I would be immensely grateful for any information regarding his whereabouts and his health. I realize the likelihood of finding a single person in the mountains is slim. Nevertheless, you are a traveling undead, armed to the teeth. If you fail, who else stands a chance? He is an excellent, if somewhat flamboyant, scientist. For years, he studied the fauna of the barren lands, paying special attention to all manner of beasts. I do not need to explain how hazardous of an endeavor that is. Of course he was well aware of the danger. He can take care of himself. His notes and observations are a unique and extremely valuable source of knowledge, as well as an attempt to document these strange lands and their inhabitants. During his travels, we kept in touch as much as was possible. Sometimes he would stop by and visit me at my former home. I know that he set out for the mountains a long while ago. Since then, I have not heard from him. Thank you. My friend, Frank Overmeyer, was a graduate of the University of Kentucky. Always impeccably dressed and clean-shaved, as much as traveling through the barren lands allowed. You will recognize him by a monocle and yellow elements in his garments, or by his notes. Maybe you have even found some of them yourself. If you find any trace...
Good you're here. I was about to go and find you. While you were away, something amazing happened. A woman in need arrived at our place. Try to help her, yeah? Do that for me and I'll owe you. She's nearby, but don't get trigger happy, okay? You need anything? Or maybe you came back with something that will help us deal with our problem. Damn, great job. You even managed to do it before the end of the world. All right, since that is now out of the way, time to find the right place. I found the promising spot, although it wasn't easy. See that big mountain? Cliché, I know, but I sense there the potential for a successful summoning ritual. We have a teeny tiny problem, though. Nah, that wouldn't be a problem. We just gunned down the beast, done and dusted. No, the problem is that the passage is closed. I sense that nearby spirit totems are somehow connected to the rest. Maybe we can use that to our advantage. Go and investigate them. Make an offering, do a rain dance, gobble up some mushrooms, or just get plain wasted. They seem to react to a word. Skeetsy. Whatever it means. And don't even ask me how I know that. It's something from my past life. Details I've long forgotten. But the word came to my mind when I saw these totems. Sometimes I wonder how many strange memories have slipped from my head, and how many things I just can't remember. But enough about that. Go. You've got work to do.
Hey, handsome. I have it on good authority that you never refuse to help a lady in need. Know that it was very rude, but I will forgive you if you help me. Let's put that aside, like bones after a bloody dinner. I need your help in getting my garments back. Skin, to be precise. Not just any skin, my skin. Do you think I parade Skyclad by choice? Believe me, I would rather be showing myself in a much better light. Alas, my property was stolen and hidden in the city. What's more, those vile little people read too much nonsense and created magic salt circles and other symbols around their treasures. Those are impenetrable barriers for beings like me. That's why I need your help. The undead said you'd definitely agree. He's a cutie, isn't he? Thanks, and good luck. I'll be waiting impatiently like a young Wendigo for fresh blood.
This may be useful. I like where this is going. Wind. Looks like a useful little thing. Ooh, I like this one. That will come in handy.
I can't.
How can I help you?
Oblivion. I'm feeling light. Some bandages. Thank you.
to hell! Reduced to ashes!
Bullets and arrows need them all. Oh, I was just looking for those. What's this now? Friendly advice, don't get back up. Maybe useful. Thank you. just looking for those. It's never enough. What does this one do? These to good use.
Begone! Bullseye! Oh, good. Hurt now. Don't get up.
Life.
You must have come across notes about the fauna of these strange lands. I am proud to point out that the author is a good friend of mine. He is a man of many talents. Yes? What did you find out? Don't keep me in the dark. Slowly, and from the very beginning, what did you find? Yes, that is his writing style. His own hand wrote these words. The monocle belonged to him. Did you find anything else? Apart from that, the skeleton had no distinguishing marks, I presume? Shreds of cloth, visible bone damage, evidence of previous fractures, anything? A part of me wants to deny what you have found. Let myself believe that it could not be him, that it was a member of his science team instead. But all the evidence points to my friend. Thank you for bringing me this news. Now, if you will excuse me, I need to be alone for a while.
Dusted. Bleeding out ain't nice at all. Done and dusted. just looking for those. Filth.
I can't.
Never forget the sight. Oh, how beautiful it smells. Makes me recall the screams, the blood splattering on my face when I retrieved it. An event of monumental importance to each of us. An event one will never forget. Thank you kindly, but don't think I'm gonna let you leave here without a reward. You have the map, right? Give it to me, I'll mark some places for you. Secret dark places. Perfect for hiding victims. Or what's left of them. You know, winter supplies. Go now, even I need some privacy when changing clothes.
I could count on you, especially in matters as delicate as Sweet Mary. She's marvelous, isn't she? I can't wait to see her wearing a new skin. Oh, all my bones rattle with anticipation. Oh, look at me.
New favorite thing. Spicy. Jobs. Just what I was looking for. That's a nice little thing. Just looking for those. Lost and recovered. I could use a bag or two.
Under such favorable circumstances. Yes, this place is perfect. The veil between our worlds is thinnest here. And this place, meat and bones, perfect building blocks for our new body. You did well, Spark. You just set your whole world on fire. As a reward for your faithful but blind service, you will receive a gift from us. You will be the first to see our birth in this world. You will become the first victim on our altar of immortality. Then, we will feast upon this world and the creatures that inhabit it. We'll suck them dry. Freedom at last. sweet thrill of victory. The villain is slain, the hero victorious, finally free. My fool, you'll never be free. We created you, granted you powers and abilities that exceed those of mere mortals, and yet you are but a tool, a wayward soldier of a cause way beyond your understanding. Without us, you have no purpose. You will find no peace, no escape, no place to call home. As you wander aimlessly until the end of days, you will realize all you achieved was in vain. You will witness the spread of the curse and the end of the civilization of man. And there will be us, waiting, and you will grovel before us. For we are eternal, and you are ours for eternity.
Lands with a vengeance in my chest, 'cause I